So hello everyone, welcome to Brainwave Chess Club. Today we are going to see an immortal game played by John Nunn. John Nunn is a 3-time world champion in chess problem solving. Also he is a chess writer and a mathematician. His opponent is Alexander Bilyovsky, who is a Slovenian and Ukraine grandmaster. So this game was played in 1985, in which John Nunn had the black pieces and Alexander had the white pieces. So without further ado, let's check it out. So Alexander started the game via the move d4, knight to f6 by John, c4, g6, knight to c3, bishop to g7, e4, d6, black goes for the king's Indian defense, f3, black castles, bishop to e3, knight bd7, queen to d2, preferring for long side castle, c5, striking in the center. So white played here d5, knight to e5 by black, and here a kind of inaccuracy by white, h3, because it weakens the g3 square. So John immediately played knight to h5, going for the g3 square. So white played bishop to f2, guarding the g3 square, and John decided to play the move f5. And the best move here from white's perspective is to play g4, and after f into g4, h into g4, knight to f4. Obviously black is slightly better over here, but it's playable for white. But the move which Alexander played here is e into f5. And now feel free to pause the video and find the best move which John played here. So congratulations to find the move rook into f5. So many of you might be thinking, wait, hold on, what after g4? Black is losing a piece. But this is exactly what black wants. So white played here g4, and black played here rook into f3. So the f3 rook is untouchable over there because white is losing his queen. So white played here pawn into h5, and black played a brilliant move over here, queen to f8. So this move doesn't allow the white king to castle, because the f2 bishop will be hanging. So white played here knight to e4, guarding the f2 bishop, and in the game bishop to h6 was played, but black has a better move over here. So feel free to pause the video and fight the best move for black here. So congratulations who found the move queen to f5. This comes with a direct attack on the knight, and trust me, this knight doesn't have a good square to go. Because let's see, if the knight goes to g3, then after rook into g3, bishop into g3, queen to e4 nabs a piece. So knight to g3 is not possible. And let's see if the knight goes to c3, then knight to d3 check is deadly. Because after bishop into d3, rook into d3, this queen doesn't has a good square to go. Because let's see if the queen goes to e2, then rook into c3 and pawn into c3, and after bishop into c3, white is again losing a piece. So queen to e2 is not possible. And let's see if the queen goes to c2, then rook to e3 check is deadly. This comes with a direct discover on the queen. So white king has to go to d1 to guard the queen, and after queen to d1, queen to h5 check is coming. So here very few options exist for white, but all leads to disaster. Let's see each by turn. If white blocks the check via the move knight to e2, then rook to f3 is very strong. And in the next few moves, black is going to play bishop to f5 and bishop to h6. So let's say if white saves his bishop via the move bishop to e1, then bishop to f5 is anyways going to come. And after you move your queen to somewhere like b3, then rook to d3 check is just winning on the spot. Because now you cannot even block with the bishop, because bishop to h6 is coming. And let's see, if you go to c1, then also bishop to h6 is going to come, and this is a completely winning position for black. And let's see if the white king goes to d2 or c1, it's just the same, because after king to d2, rook to e5 is coming with the same threat of bishop to f5 and bishop to h6. So here white has to play bishop to e3 to block the bishop to h6 check, but now comes rook into e3, and now white has to capture after king into e3, but not now bishop to h6 check, but bishop to d4 check. And after the king goes again to d2, bishop to f5 with a direct attack on the queen, And let's say after the queen goes to somewhere like d1, queen to g5 check is anyways going to come. And now there is a mate in 2, doesn't matter wherever the king goes. If the king goes to e2, then after queen to b2 and king to e1 and queen to f2 is a checkmate. And let's say if the king goes to directly e1, then after queen to g3 and king to f1 and queen to f2 is again a checkmate. So queen to f5 was a very long variation, and obviously it's very difficult to find it on the board. So in the game after knight to e4, bishop to h6 was played, attacking the queen, and white played here queen to c2, and black played here queen to f4, which is actually a mistake. So in the game knight to e2 was played, but white can actually capture here now on f3, and after knight into f3, king d1, bishop to f5, white has a good move over here. So can you please pause the video and try to find the best move for white here. So congratulations who found the move bishop to g3, because after queen into e4, queen into e4 and bishop into e4 and bishop to g2, white is an exchange up and there are no more threats on the white's king now. So this should have been a better continuation for white here. But in the game knight to e2 was played instead of knight to f3. So after knight to e2, black played here rook into f2. And now you cannot even capture the f4 queen because the queen on c2 will be hanging. So white played here knight into f2. But now comes knight to f3 check, and after king to d1, queen to h4, attacking the f2 knight. And now the knight has to go to d3 to guard the e1 square because queen to e1 is a checkmate. So white played here knight to d3. But now comes bishop to f5, pinning the knight. So white played here knight to c1, over protecting the d3 knight. But now comes knight to d2. And now you can see that the knight on d2 is well placed, and also it is planning to come from c4 to e3. So white played here h into g6, and after h into g6, bishop to g2 was played in the game. But let's see if you play a move like b3 over here to guard the c4 pawn. But now comes queen to e4, attacking the rook. And after you save your rook, queen to e3 is coming, again attacking the rook. And after the rook comes to g2, here comes the final blow, queen to f3. And now you have to block with the bishop, but now you lose the g2 rook. So b3 was not possible in that position. So white had played bishop to g2, but in that case you lose the c4 pawn, and now knight to e3 is the threat. So white played here queen to f2, trying to exchange the queens, but now comes knight to e3 check, and after king to e2, queen to c4. And now this is a completely winning position for black. But white tried a couple of few moves over here. White played here bishop to f3, but now comes rook to f8, putting pressure on the f-file. And after rook to g1, knight to c7. And now you can see that the a1 rook is attacked, and you cannot even play a move like b3 over here because queen to c3 is coming. And if you save your rook, queen to d2 is coming, and in this case you lose your queen because after king to f1, knight to e3 is coming, and you have to give up your queen. So b3 is not possible in that position. And let's say after knight to c7 you simply save your rook via the move rook to b1, but now comes knight to d4, and after king to f1 you simply lose a piece. So after knight to c7 in the game, white played king to d1, but it's still losing because now comes bishop into d3. And now there are two threats. The a1 rook is also hanging, and the knight to e3 check is also coming. So let's see if you save the rook via the move rook to b1, but now comes knight to e3 check, and after king to e1, queen to b4 check. And now you have to block with the queen, but now comes knight to c7 check, and you are losing your queen. So after bishop into d3, white resigned. So thanks for watching guys. Please do like, share and subscribe to our channel. We will be coming up with more interesting and amazing videos like this.